His friends still live. His friends still fight. Their cause is not forlorn. The night is dark and dreadful, but we may yet see the dawn. Though Erdria is racked with darkness, suffering, and pain, the Luminary's light can shine upon this land again.
Oh, you're awake! You're alert! You're alive! Your breath was getting shorter, you couldn't breathe the water, but look at you now! It's an unequivocal miracle! Queen Marina!
Thank you.
You say our guest has finally recovered from his wounds? Then let us expedite the plan. It must be done, and soon.
Your Majesty!
Don't fear for me. I'm not done yet. Until my work is finished, I'll find the strength to carry on. I shall not be diminished. Ah, there you are, old friend. Or should I say, new fish? You make a finer flounder than I'd ever dared to wish. When first my subjects brought you here, it gave me such a shock to see you bruised and broken like a ship wrecked on the rocks. The Lord of Shadows thinks you dead. The sea swarms with his spies. I changed you to this fishy form to hide you from his eyes. Many troubled months have come and gone since your arrival. As you slept, my healers strove to safeguard your survival. You cannot know how glad I am to see you fully healed. But soon the spell will fade, and you must once more take the field. I have a plan to see you safe. That's all I've ever wished. If all goes well, you'll soon know what it feels like to be fished. Forgive my haste. These strange events must take you by surprise. You have so many questions. I can see it in your eyes. I saw you battle bravely by the World Tree's holy heart. I saw the Lord of Shadows tear your fellowship apart. Strive to fell the fiend, and how your plans were vexed. When you are ready, follow me to see what happened next.
Thank you.
An eon's passed since last I brought a human to this cave. It is the private parlor of the Queen Beneath the Waves. Behold the Pearl of Wisdom, jewel of we the ocean's daughters. It lets its bearer view the world through any drop of water. I've summoned up a thunderstorm to saturate the ground. Now, let's ascend into the rain and take a look around. Whenever you are ready, touch your fin against the pearl, and you shall see what's come to pass there in your airy world. The once fair land of Erdria is now a ravaged shell. When Mordiggan destroyed its heart, the Holy World Tree fell. Upon its fall, the world was with a searing storm despoiled. Trees and grasses burned to ashes, lakes and rivers boiled. Burning boulders fell to earth and pulverized the land. Mountains cracked, and realms were racked at his unholy hand. In one fell swoop, the Lord of Shadows ended countless lives. The lucky few who rode the storm out struggle to survive. Their days are filled with desperation, misery, and tears. I see them quake and tremble, but I cannot calm their fears.
Our homes are gone. Our families and friends, too. All we have left is our lives. We can't just sit down and die. We have to keep walking.
We have to keep following the hero. They say he's built a fortress south of Heliodor. If we can make our way there, we'll be safe.
Don't give up, okay? This hero guy won't let us down. Once we get to the last bastion, everything will be fine. You'll see.
A few more short steps lead from darkness into dawn. Safe haven awaits.
Amid the black depths of despair, a spark of light still shines. A man who gives the people hope in these benighted times. Yet that light too shall soon succumb to evil's ceaseless claim. Only you can take that spark and kindle it to flame. Yggdrasil has crashed to earth. Her light has disappeared. In her place, the Lord of Shadows, Citadel of Fear. He took the sacred world tree's power and now makes it his own. Foul Mordigan commands the world from his unholy throne. His forces seek to steal the souls of every last survivor. His flying servants sweep the skies. The seas swarm with his divers. Alizarin, the fiend that seeks to devastate my nation. Another one of Mordigan's detestable creations. I've cast a spell to hold him back, but need it to be stronger. The barrier's at breaking point and cannot last much longer. I'd hoped that I could save my realm. It was a foolish notion. Compared to his, my strength is but a raindrop in the ocean. Ere long, the barrier will fall, and Nautica will too. Marauding beasts may take my life, but they shall not take you. Our time grows short. I fear my kingdom's race is nearly run. My place is with my subjects now. We face our fate as one. Curious you are, my friend. I showed you fearful sights, and yet those wide and watery eyes still gleam with limpid light. It seems that grief and tragedy have followed you since birth. Cruel fate's dark plan has stalked you to the corners of the earth. And yet you've weathered every blow, prevailed against all strife. You've brushed with death a thousand times, yet still you have your life. It is the will of Yggdrasil that you are still alive. It is your fate to save this world. For this, you must survive. Brother, bright luminary, let the light shine on the world again. Find the fading sparks of hope and kindle them to flame. You'll find the sparks I speak of here and there throughout the land. They are the former members of your staunch and stalwart band. The fire within their hearts will light the path that you must tread. Find your friends and bring an end to this dark age of dread. While the Luminary lives, there's hope for people still. You cannot fail. You must prevail. It is the World Tree's will.
Beware! The barrier shakes and breaks!
The Lord of Shadow's followers give fond farewell short shrift. I had so much to tell you, but it seems I must be swift. Do not lose heart. Do not look back until your time is through. Remember, you're the Luminary. We believe in you.
Citizens of Nordica, give your lives to the Lord of Shadows.
John's hooked himself a big un. Could it be the legendary man-eating mackerel? Let's reel him in and find out! Yes! I caught something! I actually caught something! Blue John's gonna eat tonight! Maybe there is some good in this forsaken world after all. Who the heck are you? And what are you doing on the end of my hook? I don't care how hungry you are, you don't go pinching the bait off another man's line. Hey, now. Don't cry, sonny. Look. I don't know what's got you sniffling, but it must be something serious. So listen, Blue John's gonna help you out. We fisher folk have gotta look after each other, ain't we? You can stay the night in my hut. There's none too many safe places left in this rotten world, but it'll do you for a day or two. When you're ready, you can head over to the last bastion. They'll see you, right? The fella running the place is a bony... Right, now that's decided. Let's head for shore. Hold on tight, lad. Things are about to get choppy. Hi there, Sonny. So you finally roused yourself from your slumbers, eh? Blue John would say good morning. But there ain't no morning to speak of these days. You hadn't noticed? Why, we've seen nothing but dark sky since the day of the disaster. Just look at the state of it. There was an almighty booming and rumbling, and then great gouts of blackness started billowing up from the castle over in Heliodor. Since then, nothing's been right. That was the last time any of us saw the sun. That ain't good. We better hide, and fast. That was a close one. Them monsters started pouring out of Heliodor Castle about the same time as the blackness. The rotters seem to think they own the place. They've never come so near before, though. They'll be looking for food, I'll warrant. And there Blue John was, thinking he'd found himself a safe spot. Listen, seems the victuals round these parts are set to get mighty scarce. I hate to send you packing, Sonny, but I reckon you'd best be on your way. You'll be safer over at the last bastion, anyhow. Go on and get yourself over there before the monsters spot you. That hero feller'll look after you, I'm sure. He's a good un, that one. A spark of hope in these dark old times. Steer a course due west until you hit Cobblestone Falls. The last bastion lies just beyond. Mind how you go now, Sonny.
Thank you. Sandy, there you are. And where did you run off to, might I ask? Oh. Oh my, it's really you, isn't it? You're alive, and you've come back to us. Oh, I've been so worried, especially after, well, we heard such awful things. Oh, Sandy, you're right, of course. This is the best news I could have hoped for, and here I am. Blubbering like a baby. Welcome home. It's not quite the cobblestone we grew up in, is it? No, we've been through a lot. After you left, this terrible man named Jasper came. I'll never forget his eyes. They were so cold. He rounded us all up in the center of the village, and then he ordered his men to kill us. But we were lucky. Not everyone is as cruel as Jasper. No, another soldier came and told him to stop. He said there was no need to take our lives. But that didn't stop them burning the village to the ground and locking us all up in the castle. Still, that one good man made sure we came to no harm. Sorry, Sandy, you're right. He's just got home after a long journey. He doesn't want to hear me blathering on. Come on, let's go and see the one person who'll be even happier to see you than me. Thank you.
Come on, girls, put your backs into it. The boys are out there doing the fighting, so it's up to us to keep the home fires burning.
Sorry to interrupt, Amber, but I've got big news.
Hello, Gemma, love. What's got you so excited,
Well, you're not going to believe this, but there's someone very special here to see you.
My little soldier. I just can't believe it's you. After all the awful things that happened, I was sure you were...
When the disaster struck, so many people lost their lives. The sun vanished, and those terrible monsters appeared all over the place. Even those of us who were lucky enough to survive were so drained and desperate that we almost lost the will to live.
And then the hero appeared just when we needed him. He did all he could to help people, no matter who they were or where they were from. He fought off the monsters and brought everyone here to safety. Without him, I dread to think what would have become of us. And now, thanks to him, the place you once knew as Cobblestone has become the last bastion, humanity's safe haven in a world beset by darkness. Would you believe we've even got the King of Heliodor camped out here? Look, I know he was the one who ordered the village to be burned, but I'm sure he had his reasons. Things aren't always as they seem, love. He may be the last person you want to see, but you should go and talk things through with the king. Your grandfather would have wanted you to at least try. Just pop your head round the door of his tent, will you, love? For me. It's the one in the middle of the camp with the two flags. And be polite.
Thank you. So, you are alive and well, I see. You have nothing to fear. I have regained my senses at last. The living nightmare that began for me on the day of your birth has ended. Though in truth, I remember little of what I did. I have inflicted so much pain on so many. On you. I do not ask for forgiveness. I do not deserve it. All I ask is that I be allowed to atone, to pay for my crimes by protecting those who remain. Tell me, do you recall what happened on that fateful day? The events that came to pass beneath Yggdrasil's branches? I see. I recall nothing. All I know is that whomever or whatever had me in its grasp for all those years left me there. And when at long last I returned to my senses, I was here. There is something else I must ask you. Tell me, do you know if my daughter is alive? I see.
Your Majesty, the hero has returned. He brings more survivors seeking sanctuary.
Come. You must meet he to whom we owe our survival. Though you may not wish to at first. Welcome back, Hendrik. Well, what news?
The forces of darkness amass at the gates of Heliodor. They will strike, and soon. Sire, the people must be removed to safety. Men! All the signs are that our enemy will strike tonight. To arms! They shall not find us unprepared!
As you see, he is as eloquent as ever. But you must forgive him. He has fought harder than any of us. He has sacrificed more than anyone. Which is why his burden must be lightened. It is time that your differences were set aside, Luminary. Mankind needs you. Hendrik needs you. Will you stand beside him? I can well understand the ill will you feel. But there is no other save yourself. It is time that your differences were set aside, Luminary. Good. If we are able to withstand the assault tonight, we may yet survive. Join the troops outside the fortress when you are ready. Thank you.
Thank you. Hey, you must be our newest recruit. They say you made it all the way to the last bastion under your own steam. Well, I'm impressed, I've got to tell you. You can obviously handle yourself there, or you were born lucky. Well, either way, I'm sure we can find a use for you. Follow me. Right, here's your spot. Just face that way, and when the monsters come, stick the pointy end of your sword in them. Oh, don't look so worried. You'll be fine.
Enemy forces! Here they come! Yes.
Positions, men!
Yeah! Thank you.
Behind you! Never let down your guard. You will need to pull your weight if we are to escape this one. Have at them!
Our beloved commander, righteous and best of the spectral sentinels, spake truly when spake of thee, Hendrik. Thou art without a shred of guile. Any other would have fled the field long ago. But I have no complaints. Our reward for tearing thee limb from limb shall be a handsome one indeed. Fools! Wherefore gapest ye like ninnies? Kill him! Prepare to die! Luminary! Mugga!
Behind me!
This world is ours.
Our triumph was never in doubt.
Retreat! Move your bones!
Commander, a message from His Majesty. He wishes to speak with you. Both of you.
Right away.
It seems we owe you both a debt of gratitude. You have proven your strength and your ability to work together. It is time. Time to bring light back to this benighted land. The fiend that usurped my throne must be ousted. Heliodor Castle must be reclaimed. And you, my loyal servants, must lead the charge.
But sire...
I do not give these orders lightly, Hendrik. My spies have found a means by which we might gain an advantage. The city's sewers can be entered from the cliffs in the side of the hill atop which Heliodor stands. You will use these sewers to infiltrate the castle from beneath.
Thank you.
His key will unlock the gate.
But sire, who will command our forces in my absence? If the enemy renews the attack, we will be slaughtered.
We will not. We will be prepared. Prepared to draw them out, leaving the castle unguarded. The usurper must be overthrown while we have the chance. We strike now, or we never see the light of day again.
Please, Your Majesty, we cannot allow yet more lives to be lost.
Precisely. Which is why you must quell the darkness at its source. We seize our one opportunity, or we consign ourselves to despair. It is as simple as that. Or do you question the wisdom of your king? My subjects have shown me the depth of their courage. I trust in their ability to endure this one last assault. And I order you to do likewise. You are our last hope. Do not let us down.
Wait, love. Mr. Hendrick, sir. I couldn't have a quick word with my boy, could I? I won't be long, I promise.
As long as it is quick.
Oh. So you're heading off again, are you?
Well, just you be sure to listen to Sir Hendrik and do as you're told. And don't you dare go giving up, ever. Just look at me, eh? Something's wrong with my eyes now, too. Must be all this squinting in the dark. Well, only one remedy for that. You'll just have to bring back the light. Promise?
Time is short. We must be on our way.
You'll look after my boy, won't you, Sir Hendrik?
Obsidian, see the lady back to safety.
Ha ha.